Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today I will be talking about the latest news, but we just got it confirmed that the land is still rising and not just on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So we have something to work with in today's video for sure. Magma seems to be accumulating under Mount Fagradalsfjall again, now at 12 to 16 kilometers depth, but our experts just confirmed it. And just before I sat down with this voiceover, we had an earthquake measuring 3.0 in Grindavik or just by Mount Thorbjörn, where the whole show started just over a year ago. And it is really not a surprise, as I've been saying again and again recently. Mother Earth is just taking a deep breath, as we have seen on the seismometers recently. And the next chapter might just be around the corner, but my guess is within 2 months, but who knows? Grindavik might be telling us something tonight, but if this next chapter will lead to an eruption, I can't say. But if I were to guess, I would say that we will have an eruption on the peninsula this year. It's just too much going on. But let's move to yesterday's earthquake. It was magnitude 3, which is perhaps not newsworthy as such, but the location is a bit off though. So I'm swapping to this new satellite image that you can find on an Icelandic Facebook page I'm linking to. It was shot just a few days ago, and as you can see, my country is covered with snow, and we rarely see the peninsula look like this, or the topography, where the plate boundaries and other features in a landscape literally pop out. So I'm gonna do a short sightseeing tour, and first we can see the outlines of the lava that came up in Geldingadalir. It's still warm, so the snow doesn't stick, but here in Iceland we often use such lava fields as baking ovens. If you come to Iceland, feel free to give it a go. Many people make excellent bread from ovens like this. Then we have the Grímsvötn volcanic system, the one that stretches all the way into the capital region, or the elephant in the room. But the earthquake yesterday occurred in the Hangit volcanic system next door, the only system with a central volcano, and quite big actually. And the outlines in the landscape around Hengil have their own story to tell about its capability. And the earthquake yesterday occurred just around here, where we have relatively new hot water drill holes to power up the nearby power plant. So I can't say that this location is a total surprise, especially since there have been earthquakes in the Hengil system recently, and most of them are around here, a place called Hrómundartindur, but you can call it Bob if it's easier for you. And it is the second magma chamber of Mount Hengil. And to northeast from Mount Hengil, we can see Lake Þingvallavatn, but it's frozen now. And in the middle of the lake, we can see the 2,000-year-old island that popped up during the last eruption in the Hengil system. And to bring you a bit closer to the earthquake location, I'm using this recent drone shot from my video about the nearby earthquake town Hveragerði, and I'm linking to it. And we are literally looking over the plate boundaries that actually cross the road between Reykjavik and the south coast of Iceland. And yesterday's earthquake occurred just around here. And this is also the largest chunk of lava on the Reykjanes Peninsula, the place where we get the magnitude 6 plus earthquakes every 50 years or so, and the last one was over 50 years ago. So I do tend to mention earthquakes around there, even though they aren't all that big, since overall the seismic unrest on the peninsula is just so unusual. But let's move on to other news. We also learned that land rise in Askja continues, but it is winter and our experts have lost the connection to many of the equipment up there. But they could, however, confirm constant land uplift. But in that case, by Lake Askja, we might have to wait for even decades for an eruption to take place. So we are not losing any sleep over that one, but we better treat it with respect though. And the news from Grímsvötn volcano under Vatnajökull is by far more interesting. There is still land uplift there. The volcano is clearly getting ready for an eruption, and in this case it is Iceland's most active volcano, and we rarely have to wait for long after we see the first signs. So we are told that an eruption could occur at any time, but we have heard that one before though, especially after the glacier floods last year, but they do often trigger an eruption. So we should keep an eye on that one as well, but this is the status today. What we know for sure is that we have land rise on three locations at the moment, and way more seismic activity than usual, and I'm still convinced that 2022 will be even more newsworthy than last year. But how things will unfold exactly is still unclear, but then that is what makes this all so interesting. We just don't know. And now, since things are a bit more calm, I'm using the time for this huge project where I cover most towns in Iceland. And I would be very disappointed if those of you who are here mainly for my content about geology would skip some of the episodes, because we do have towns on the plate boundaries. And I have two such episodes already online, actually, and way more to come. But the next episode will be the longest one so far, where we discover the capital of Northern Iceland, packed with footage and information about this strange tribe up north. And I did some flying around this weekend, despite the cold, but we are seeing some sun again, and I can't tell you how nice it is. The winters are just so dark. And I had a great time as well with the Northern Lights last night. Came back with a frozen Nikon, hot memory card and a dead battery, after shooting close to 1000 frames of time-lapse material like this. And I'm still working on the image process, and it will be online soon. But this is a sample. So I can't complain over a view, as I'm sending you best regards from my home country, the Volcano Island, Iceland.